We are getting some large catastrophic fires that are burning across the western U.S. and they burn extremely hot, hotter than we have had traditionally, and they remove a lot of the native plant communities. And so we can be left with these sites that are denuded of vegetation, look like a moonscape. When we have a barren landscape, that ends up being a vacuum for weeds to move into. If we don't get native plants back on the landscape, we're going to have more and more fires.
Our native species provide better habitat for wildlife. They have a higher forage quality. They tend to be more resistant to fire because they tend to dry out later in the season.
With a lot of these invasive species, they are much better fuel for the fire, so the fires can spread faster and burn hotter.
Reseeding with native species helps protect against the things we're trying to fight, like cheatgrass and erosion, which lead to bigger and more intense fires.
So land managers, we recognize we need to get native species back on the landscape. And then we look at our landscapes and how much has been burned. A lot of times we don't even have enough seed to go around. And then also the lack of performance of the seed. It's a really big challenge. We've made a number of different steps forward in restoration over the years. Recently, there's been genetic work that's been done. And we feel another level of success that we can now have is with seed enhancement technologies, such as seed coatings. We've developed a number of important seed coating technologies that we feel can improve rangeland restoration efforts.
Sagebrush is a really good example of a species that's difficult to reseed. It tends to clog cedars. It doesn't disperse very well out of a cedar or from the plant on the landscape.
So here we have some sagebrush seed. It's quite fine, almost looks like sawdust. This material is very difficult to work with. So what we've done is take this seed and those non-seed parts and conglomerate it with clay and other filler material in our rotary seed coater and groups this material into these small pellets. We can broadcast this out across the landscape. It allows for a more uniform distribution. We're not only working with sagebrush, but a number of different species. We have approximately 8 different seed coatings that we've developed, and each of those address different limiting factors impairing restoration efforts. Now, an exciting part of our research is let's apply them to other species and see if they're going to perform just as well. Then we go out in these remote rangeland areas and put seeds in the ground. We have sites across Utah as well as throughout the Great Basin because it helps us to have various weather conditions, soil types, so we can really get a feel for how our technologies are working. Then we can come back in the springtime and see how many emerged, and in the summer and how many survived, and then the following year.
One of the seed coatings that we've had a lot of success with is fungicides. With blue bunch wheatgrass, we've seen an average of a 60% increase in plant emergence.
And I have noticed the difference that the ones that are germinating and are doing better lots of times have the coatings on them. They have the fungicide in them that helps them to really establish faster.
If we can get them to grow through the first year, they'll be there on the landscape for years after that. I'm optimistic the land managers, as they see evidence in the field that these technologies will work, that they'll want to adopt them. They're looking for solutions. So we're excited to be able to help the restoration efforts.